I consider our expertise in the healthcare area to be not only about the methodologies, but also about our facility to identify and quickly source appropriate data for the problem at hand. Sometimes that means we need to get multiple data sets. Part of our value added that we bring to bear is that we can identify the right data for the issue at hand and make best use of it. One of the early kinds of questions that we try to help lawyers with is in the realm of class certification. Oftentimes the lawyers try to recruit plaintiffs, individuals who use the drug and suffer the problem, and they try to create what's called a class of those individuals, but there are rules in the courts as to when you can and when you can't certify a class. One of the key questions has to do with how common are the claims in question across the individuals. On the one hand, it would seem that in many instances, individuals' claims, individuals' profiles are sufficiently different from one another that a class-wide handling of all those concerns doesn't seem justified. On the other hand, if you had to litigate literally hundreds of thousands, tens of thousands or even more of cases, that could get prohibitively costly from a judge's standpoint. So there's this kind of balance that needs to be struck, finding those times when a class should be certified. We often help counsel, not so much necessarily in the litigation itself. Beside the litigation, there's this whole exercise of when do you settle and when do you go forward?